The hardware used in the CTRIO2 motion videos looks like this. Starting down here at the PLC, we have a 4-slot 205 base with the Do-more processor, an input simulator, and the new CTRIO2 module. The servo motor is driven by a sure step motor driver through this extension cable. Power for the stepper motor is supplied by this sure step power supply. The stepper motor is connected to a threaded screw, which moves a carriage mounted on a rail. The MPN proximity sensor detects when the carriage passes and feeds its output back to the CTRIO2 module, where it can be used as a limit. I like this little sensor because it has an LED in it that lights up when it detects something. That makes debug a snap. The encoder is also fed back to the CTRIO module so we can use it to validate positioning. There's a 24-volt DC power supply powering the encoder near proximity sensor, which isn't shown here. The great thing about this is, I didn't need any other modules in my PLC system. The CTRIO2 handles everything I need. The CTRIO2 even comes with jumpers that you can install on an internal header to tie all the commons together. That really helps clean up the external wiring and makes your life a whole lot easier. For these motion videos, we've tied all of the input commons together and we've tied all the output Ys together. We're using the Cs as the output signals. The best part of this is you can swap out the CTRIO2 module anytime you want because all of the configuration information is stored on the Do-more processor. You don't have to worry about reconfiguring the module when you replace it. Just shove the new one in and turn the PLC on. The Do-more processor configures the CTRIO2 for you. Please understand that this hardware was set up just for demo purposes. It's not supported or sold by Automation Direct, so please don't call tech asking about it, and don't call sales to try and buy one. Also note that there are no over-travel limits here, so please don't think of this as a complete hardware setup. It's just intended to quickly demonstrate how to use the CTRIO2 functions and the Do-more processor. And of course, whenever you're doing motion, always start moving things slow until you can make sure they work, and then speed them up when you feel confident it's all going to work the way you expect. Well, that's all there is to the hardware setup we're using. All the part numbers shown can be purchased at AutomationDirect.com. You'll really like the prices there, and the free shipping for all orders over $49, well, that just can't be beat. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series for more on using motion. And as always, please send us any comments you may have. We appreciate the feedback. Spend less, do more from Automation Direct.